Tay4 says, in this video I want to show you how to snap player to platform via Unity ECS system. So let's dive in. The plan is as follows. Handle snap on the side of the independent snap player to platform system. And that's all. We have all necessary components to implement this feature. First of all, let's add new public field entity ground hit entity in the player movement component data. Then we can go to the player aspect and create new getter and setter for ground hit entity. We'll set it from player detection system, so let's go to the system. Inside it, let's extend handle ground collision detection method, create new native list, distance hit, hits, new native list, distance hit, allocator.temp job. Let's change invocation from checkbox to overlap box and pass ref hits to function. We need to check if the player is grounded. If so, assign hits at index 0.entity to the player aspect ground hit entity. Don't forget to dispose hits. We don't want any handling allocations. Okay, it's time to create a new ECS system. Call it snap player to platform system. Let's add partial keyword to the struct and implement the iSystem interface. Next, add onCreate, onUpdate and onDestroy methods. With burst compile attributes, of course. Then add two attributes to the struct, also burst compile and update in group type of simulation system group. This system should work after all other working systems, so let's write order last equal true to ensure it. Okay, let's copy paste get entity command buffer method from another system. Note, I wrote ECB utils to do this, which I will implement at the end of the course. During general code refactoring. So I will explain how to work with it. In the onUpdate method, let's write var player component data equals systemapi.getSingleton player component data. We need to check if player is dead, if so, return. The same goes for the isGrounded state. We only want to change the player velocity when we are on the ground, not in the air. Now let's cache player movement component data, ground hit entity to local variable. It will increase readability. Last check, we want to be sure that our ground element is moving platform. If not, return. Now let's cache platform movement component data via systemapi.getComponent. At this point, we are sure it is moving platform. And we want to schedule the job. Job handle equals new snap player to platform job, pass two parameters, ECB, get entity command buffer ref state, and platform movement component data. Then schedule job, pass state.dependency. After that, let's call job handle.complete so we can wait for the job to complete. It's time to implement job then. Let's create new burst compile public partial struct snap player to platform job, which implements iJob entity. Add two public fields, entity command buffer and platform movement component data. In this case, we don't need parallel writer. A single thread is enough for this operation. So let's implement execute method. Pass in entity player entity, ref physics velocity, and player aspect. If movement direction is not zero, then we are moving, so let's return. I only want to snap to the player when it is standing still. Our direction is math.normalize player movement component data.movement vector, however, if its reverse movement is set to true, we need to change direction to negative. Okay, so now we can cache platform speed from component data. Let's assign platform speed multiplied by direction to the physics velocity.linear. Remember to set component. Without it, our change to the player velocity will not propagate. Okay, that's all. Let's check if everything is working in the Unity editor. Wait for the compilation process to finish and press play. Let's jump to the moving platform and... Snap is working as expected. Great job! I would like to invite you to support us on the Patreon, where you can get the exclusive code, all models, materials or code used in this series, and access to early available content. Link in the description. Thank you for your time, I'm glad you are with us and our community is growing. See you soon in the next video.